everyone, this is Abdul from Pythonist. Welcome back to another video. Sets and dictionaries are very important and powerful data structures in Python. In this video, I'm going to explain you how these data structures actually work and how we can make them much more efficient to gain the best performance. Let's get started. Dictionary is the key-value pair, while a set is simply a collection of unique keys. Both are ideal data structures to be used when your data has no intrinsic order, but does have a unique object that can be used to reference it. This reference object is called the key, while the data is the value. At this stage, we know that the lookup time on lists and tuples with no intrinsic order is big O of log n in the best case. But dictionaries and sets gives us big O of n lookups based on the arbitrary index. In addition, lists, tuples, dictionaries, and sets all have big O of 1 insertion time. And this speed is accomplished through the use of an open address hash table as the underlying data structure. However, there is a cost to use dictionaries and sets. First, they generally take a larger footprint in memory. And secondly, although the complexity for insertion and lookups is big O of 1, but the actual speed depends greatly on the hashing function that is in use. If the hash function is slow to evaluate, then any operations on dictionaries and sets will be similarly slow. Let's look at an example. So for example, if we want to store contact information of everyone in the phone book, we would like to store this information in a form that will make it simple to answer the question, what's someone's phone number in the future? So by using lists, we can store the phone numbers and name sequentially and scan through the entire list to find the phone number we needed. On the other hand, with the dictionary, we can simply have the index be the names and the values be the phone numbers. This allows us to simply look up the values we need and get a direct reference to it instead of having to read every value in our dataset. So let's try to implement this example in the code editor. First, we will implement it by using list. So I have defined a list named as contacts. One thing you should notice here is that I have defined the list of tuples to store the name and its corresponding phone number. So let's try to find a contact by scanning through the list. So I will define a function named as find_contact, which will take the list of contacts and the name we are looking the phone number for. Then I will write a for loop to iterate over this list as for n p in contacts. And if the current name is the name which we are looking for, we can simply return this phone number. Otherwise, we will return none. So let's call this function and print out the result. You can see the phone number for Matt here in the result. That's great. So let's try to implement the same example by using a dictionary. So I will define a dictionary named as contacts_dict with few contacts as key value pair inside the curly braces. So this time, to find the phone number for a name, we don't need to scan through all the elements because we have arbitrary indexes as name of the contact and we can directly access that out. For larger data, the difference between the big O of 1 lookup of the dictionary and big O of n lookup for linear search over the list is quite substantial. If on the other hand, we wanted to answer the question, how many unique first names in our contacts list, we could use the power of sets. Recall that a set is simply a collection of unique keys. This is the exact property we can utilize on our data. This is quite handy when we compare it with the list. So let's try to implement this example once again in the editor. So I have defined a list of contacts named as contacts with some duplicate first name. So first let's try to get the unique first names by using lists. So I will define a function named as unique underscore fname underscore list, which will take the list of contacts, then define a list to store the unique names, and then scan through the entire list using a for loop and split the first and last name by a space. And if the name is already in the unique names list, it's not a unique, so we will break the loop. But in the either condition, we will append this first name to the unique names list and finally return the length of unique names list. Okay, now let's try to implement this function using set. So I will define a function named as unique underscore fname underscore set, which will also take the list of contacts. Once again, we will iterate over all the items by using a for loop and split the names into first and last name. But after that, we can directly add it to the unique underscore name set, because it's going a first name only once. And finally, we will return the length of unique underscore names set. Okay, let me call these functions and print the result. You can see here are the results. But if you notice that in both cases, we must scan through all the items in our contacts list, and this loop cost us big O of n. But in the case of list, you can notice here, we must check the current name against all the unique names we have already in our list of unique names. If the current name is a new one, we add it to our list and continue through the entire list for all items in our contacts list. On the other hand, in the case of set method, instead of iterating over all unique names we have already seen, we can simply add the current name to a set of unique names. So this operation costs us just big O of 1. But if we dive a little bit deeper to expose the performance of both of these algorithms, the least algorithm outer loops contributes the big O of n factor because of the iteration of all the items, and the inner loop contributes the big O log of n factor. On the other hand, the set algorithm has no inner loop. The select.add operation is big O of 1 process that completes in a fixed number of operations regardless how large the list of contacts, and the outer loop in this case contributes big O of 1, like in the list algorithm. Because in both cases we have to iterate over all the items in the outer loop, if we combined the time complexity factor for both algorithms, we got that the list algorithm performs and big O of n log n, while the set algorithm performs in big O of n. If we track the time for both of these algorithms using a context list of 10,000 entries and 7,422 unique first names, you will see that the set algorithm will be 267 times faster. And you can imagine how drastic the difference between big O of n and big O of n log n can be. So that's enough for this video. In the upcoming video, we will understand how a hash function has been utilized to get this performance for dictionaries and sets, along with the different operations like inserting and retrieving, deletion and resizing can be performed on these data structures. So if you like this video, be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon, so you will never miss any fantastic video in the future. Thanks for watching.